everyone. We are here in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Osmania University. Let us know about the innovative project they have made to participate in Aero Design Challenge held at SRM University, Chennai.
So this is Dr. Uma Maheshwar from Mechanical Engineering Department, Osmania University. We in Engineering College believe in giving a professional education to our students, this being a professional course. We have a club called the Society of Automotive Engineers, which has a good number of students from the Department of Mechanical Engineering, also Department of Electrical Engineering. The students do various activities under this club. They actually learn by doing things in the garage. So we have built all-terrain vehicles earlier. We have built go-kart vehicles. We also recently built a racing car, a Formula racing car, which participated in a big event in national level at Delhi. And we also built three unmanned aircrafts by three different students. This is an event which is organized by Society of Automotive Engineers India every year. It's an annual event where the students from across India participate in the event. The design target that is given to students is to build an unmanned air vehicle which can fly by a radio control mechanism. There is a electrical motor powered by a battery, and the vehicle has to move around a given circuit within the specified rule book limits in about 3 minutes time. It has to carry some payload, and also it has to have good aerodynamic aspects also. So we had three teams from our college. First team is called as Phoenix, the second is Pegasus, and the third team is called as Greyhounds.
The first student who will explain about the design.
Hello, myself Abhiram. I'm one of the team captains out of three teams that participated this year in Aero Design Challenge conducted by SAE. SAE is basically the Society of Automotive Engineers. It is an organization of various automotive engineers across the country and across the world. It's also because it is in India. It is based in India and also at international level. And coming to SAE, SAE has various events conducted. Among them is one of the event is Aero Design Challenge, which we participated. We had totally three teams this year. And coming to this particular event, which is conducted by SAE, Aero Design Challenge. It has, for any SAE event, they provide a rule book, a set of rules that has to be followed by the participating teams to take under consideration, which has various aspects for different events, different events that are conducted at the event, and design considerations, different parameters that has to be followed, and various aspects of the event included in that particular rule book for each and every event. And coming to this very event of Aero Design Challenge, basically it has two categories. One is regular class and one micro class. This year, all the three teams participated from our department. Being the first year, many people were enthusiastic, and all the three teams were only in regular class. We are planning to do in micro class also in next year. And coming to design consideration which they gave, we had to build an aircraft which was supposed to be less than 5 kgs for regular class. And the design consideration only dimensions parameters were given, that the whole dimension, length as well as breadth as well as height of the whole aircraft should be within 170 inches. There's the design aspect. These are the two only design aspects that are given by the competition organizing. And coming to our aircrafts, we made three aircrafts, one of which we can see here. Basically, coming to these aircraft, they are usually called as UAVs, which refers to unmanned aerial vehicles, which are controlled by RC, means radio control. They are RC aircraft, basically called as RC aircraft, controlled by radio control. And coming to construction, We constructed the whole aircraft with wood, as it was supposed to be within 5 kgs. We constructed it with wood. We made the whole fuselage. This is the main body, which is called as fuselage. This fuselage part, we made it with plywood. These are the wings, which we made it with balsa, for example. Something like this. We had many ribs within this whole thing, on which we coated it with monocoat. This white layer, it is called as monocoat. And for back, this is called as horizontal stabilizer, elevator, and this is called as rudder, vertical stabilizer. Both these parts we made with foam, covered with balsa. And then coming to propulsion, we used BLDC motor, as only BLDC motor was allowed in the competition. No ducted fans or turbines were allowed. And for propulsion, we used BLDC motor, and which was powered by a LiPo battery, 6S and 4S LiPo battery. That's it. There's design considerations which we had to follow and which we utilized.
Okay, now we are here with the team 2, and the captain Anusha will talk about the sponsorship.
I'm Anusha, captain of Team Phoenix. I'm presently pursuing my fourth year in mechanical engineering, Osmania University. Initially, the estimated cost of our aircraft was around 70,000, and it was really difficult for us to raise the funds and complete our project. Hence, I'd like to thank our faculty advisor, Mr. Uma Maheshwar sir, who supported us throughout and who gave us contacts of the companies and the our sponsors. Without whose support, we wouldn't have completed this project. Our key sponsors are NMDC, Me Seva, Siyasat, Involute iClean, and Kalaimagal Trust Fund. And I'd also like to thank our alumni who supported us both conceptually and gave us their guidance and experience. Thank you.
Team 3, Dheeraj will talk about the budget allocations.
My name is Dheeraj Sai. I am captain of Team Griffons from University College of Engineering, Osman University Mechanical Department. So we have used a BLDC motor which we have imported from China. So it has costed us around 12,000, and we have used a LiPo battery of 6S, which have costed us around 10,000. We have done laser cutting for the balsa wood which we have used. So it has costed us around 10,000. And there are ESCs which we have used, and other wires, and remote control, which have costed around 10,000. So total budget of the aeroplane has come across 70,000.
Let's go to one of the students and let us know about the coordination. Since there are 3 teams, can you talk about the coordination?
It was really a Herculean task for us to build an aircraft, because we, being mechanical engineer, didn't have much idea about the aerodynamics. So one of the big aspect of this event is that we 3 teams were competent to each other, and that was very important because we had to stay in the hunt. As that was possible, we were competent to the competition also. When it comes to the team coordination, each and every member supported everyone, and we kept motivating ourselves when we had tough times. Even when we didn't have enough sponsorships, we kept motivating ourselves. We kept searching for a lot of companies and trying to drive some more sponsorship events. So when it comes to team management, everyone of us supported each other. That was the main, and team spirit also played a huge role in this event.
Okay. Since they participated in the SRM University, let us go and talk, let us know about the experience they had.
My name is Sudhanshu. I'm from Mechanical Engineering Department. I belong to Team Griffons. So the experience which we got is really wonderful. Right from the starting, from the fabrication of the vehicle, the knowledge which we got, the things which we experienced when the vehicle was being fabricated, the enjoyment which we had while going to the event, and at the time of event, seeing our aircraft fly is really wonderful experience. Overall, it was a really nice experience, and I also would like to mention, I would also like to thank Umameshwar sir for giving us this opportunity.
the softwares used in it?
Coming to the softwares, the basic softwares which we have used for our design are SolidWorks and AutoCAD. These are the softwares which we used for the wireframe design of our aircraft. Coming to the analysis part, we have used basically ANSYS for the drag analysis and streamline flow analysis of our airplane. And the other software for analysis which we used was XFLR5. That is the software which is especially used for this purpose only, that is airplane analysis. That's it. These are the four softwares which we used for our design.
How is it different from drone?
Basically, aeroplane can carry more weight than a drone. If a drone is powered by a motor which will be having a thrust of 7 kgs, then it can lift a weight up to 7 kgs, not more than 7 kgs. If we use a motor of 7 kgs in an aeroplane, then it will be lifting more than 7 kgs, like 8 to 9 kgs. The lifting capacity of an aeroplane is more than a drone. Then it can carry weights up to higher altitudes. A drone cannot go up to higher altitudes, whereas an aeroplane can go.
After this big project, can you give some suggestions to your juniors?
My name is Janvi and I'm from Team Pegasus. As we saw that we are three teams and we had to compete against ourselves, and we had to bring a lot of new concepts because we shouldn't copy others' designs, and the three of our designs shouldn't be the same too. So I suggest that our juniors could go for a micro class aircraft and one regular class aircraft, just two teams. And also coming to the sponsorships, it's better to go and search for companies at the initial stage, that is right after registration only, because later you'll face a lot of problems in financial issues. And also the weight, the weight buildup is huge. It's not like how we estimate it. It almost becomes 2 kgs more than what we expected. So it's always a good practice to start with a low estimation and then build up so that we can even add some innovations and stuff.
I thank Dr. Uma Maheshwar sir and mechanical engineering students for their valuable time. Let us hope such innovative projects come up and flourish in the future. Thank you.